Interesting. Maybe you don't yet know how you're going to make that impact, but you go, here's something I want to continue to pursue. All those things will make me feel more confident that you're going to come in and have a strong interview than the person that just reiterates their experience page. And as I kind of alluded to as well, our interview is about 35 or 45 minutes with two faculty members who have read your application in advance. And if the typical essay is a resume, all those insights and interesting points you're making and identifications of things that, you're basically should use your personal statement to yell at your interviewers, ask me about this. If this comes up, I really want to talk about it. I will really showcase my awareness. We're gonna have a great conversation. Here's something that, I'm gonna talk about better than everyone else. Ask me about it. When you put it in your personal statement, it's certainly going to benefit you, I think, for the other schools, for them also to feel confident about your just general awareness. But specifically for Tufts, it's potentially the introduction to what you're talking about in your interview. So rather than hoping it comes up, and I think that is a risk of a 35-minute conversation. Sometimes people leave that room and they go, I had such a great time, it was really enjoyable, but man, this didn't come up. Make sure it comes up. Find different ways to get to whatever point it is that you really think you can really showcase whatever it is that you want us to know about you. Come in with questions that potentially help with that too, but also maybe the personal statement is the first time that you can do it. If you fill it up with, by going step by step of, I have large animal, I have equine, I have research, I have aquatic, I have, I'm so well-rounded. You haven't really gone into depth for any of those things. You've just reminded me that you have them.
Gotcha.
So I think that's the only risk of kind of overpacking your application.
Can you talk a little bit more about the master's in
Yep.
conservation medicine?
Sure. So the Masters in Conservation Medicine program is one that is a standalone master's program. Within our veterinary program, we do have a few that are combined degrees that you can earn, but the MCM program is on its own. It's a full calendar year. We actually have a student this year that's part of the MCM program that actually was accepted into our DVM program and decided to defer for a year so they could do the Masters in Conservation Medicine first. I think of our standalone, it probably is the one that is most likely to have either future veterinarians or those that actually have already earned their DVM degree and then have gone on to do the master's program. It has a very big environmental and conservation, clearly, emphasis. Our school in general tends to as well. We have a very One Health focus of environmental studies, human medicine, veterinary medicine, and how they work together. The master's program has some coursework for maybe like 8 months or so, and then they have a really big research project as well. And that potentially could be field work. And sometimes some of the students will go internationally, but often will, just conduct it either in Massachusetts or their home states or, but the research component is a very big piece of it as well. So it's going to be a combination of field work and classroom. It's a full year and potentially allows you to get involved in things like public health a bit more or conservation and environmental policy. Have a better awareness of some infectious disease topics and things like that. There's some DVM applications. Clearly, which is why either prospective DVM applicants or current DVM current doctors are joining the program. And on top of that, I would just say I'm happy to give you the contact info of the director of the program. For any of our master's programs, any of our directors are happy to chat with you about. Here are the projects that our students are currently doing. here's what past graduates are currently doing, the impact that they're making, and just having a conversation if you are